The people who experienced the Holocaust must not bring a Holocaust upon another people. The world must know what is happening.
The world's worst nightmare. A nuclear arms race in the Middle East. But hidden in the desert is an atom bomb factory. The West helped build it, and it belongs to Israel.
Israel is building a huge nuclear war machine. It will end any chance of peace in the Middle East.
One man exposes an international conspiracy of silence.
If Mossad knows what he's saying, they're going to kill him. They're going to kill us all.
Something bad is going to happen.
Israel does not want peace.
Bullshit!
What if he's a plant? Probably doesn't even know it himself.
She could be Mossad.
He's up against one of the most feared secret services in the world. And they won't stop till they've got him.
I didn't want to be a hero, but no one else would do it.
This is the first man to tell the world nuclear weapons have arrived in the most troubled region on Earth, the Middle East. In doing so, he's exposed the West's opposition to nuclear proliferation as little more than a sham.
I am Mordechai Vanunu, the man behind the Sunday Times article about Israel nuclear weapons.
To all those who are calling me traitor, I am saying I am proud and happy to do what I did.
Vanunu is banned from talking to foreign media. Based on eyewitness testimony, this film is his story.
I was 22 when I started work at Dimona. Israel's most closely guarded secret.
Machon to number?
320. I was a nuclear technician, assigned to the most secret building of all. Hidden underneath are six underground levels, all top secret. I worked on level 2.
What you are about to see does not exist.
I worked there for 7 years. I told no one until now. And if they find out I'm speaking to you, I'm in great danger.
I understand. Okay?
Mordecai told me quite an amazing story of how the Israelis had built a reactor which could be seen, and that was above the ground, but the plutonium plant, which was producing this material from which weapons could be made, was built underground.
From Israel's birth, it faced hostile neighbors opposed to its very existence. Its first prime minister, Ben-Gurion, wanted the atomic bomb as a weapon of last resort. On his orders in 1958, Israel secretly began to build a nuclear plant in the Negev desert near Dimona, saying it was a textiles factory. The only glimpse the world ever had of the nuclear reactor was this biplane photo taken in 1960. Now, Vanunu claimed he'd seen what Dimona was really for.
What was below level 2?
It took me 7 years to find out. Level 5 is the most secret. But then I got a chance to see it for myself.
Night, Modi. Don't work too hard, eh?
People get careless, even the boss. I had no excuse to be down there. None. I was usually on nights when they change shifts. For a short time, there is no one about. Machines could only be for one thing, making nuclear weapons. Now I know the truth behind all the lies. I saw the models they gave the machinists to make the cores of plutonium bombs.
Vanunu claimed that later, when facing redundancy, he risked a heavy prison sentence to take photos of what he had seen.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Behind all the lies, Dimona is an atom bomb factory.
You have more photographs of this?
Yes, I have 57. I went back down again with my camera. The reactor, making plutonium, making the bombs.
Colombian journalist Oscar Guerrero was the middleman who persuaded Vanunu to sell his story and brought Hounam to Australia to assess it. If true, it was a huge scoop. Israel had been opposed to other countries in the Middle East having the bomb. In 1981, it destroyed Iraq's nuclear reactor.
We shall not allow any enemy to develop weapons of mass destruction turned against us.
Israel's leaders had always been deliberately unclear as to whether they had the bomb or not.
Israel undertook upon herself not to be the first country to introduce atomic weapons in the Middle East. This was our policy, and this is our policy today.
Vanunu's evidence suggested there was no doubt. Israel had the bomb.
What you have is very impressive. Very impressive. But we need to have more checks.
Why?
The paper needs to be sure of the facts. We need you to go through your whole story with a nuclear weapons scientist in London.
I have to leave Sydney.
If you want the story out, yes. And without him.
Please, you must not print my name. Protect me and my family, please.
Your name is your best protection. Once the world knows who you are, the Israelis will think very hard before laying a finger on you.
Think so?
Then every day you delay in publishing, I am in more danger.
Aware of the threat from Mossad, Hounam knew that he had to keep the story under wraps till publication. He considered Guerrero a liability.
It's a big story in the world. It's bigger than Watergate.
I cannot talk on the phone about this. This is a dangerous thing.
Vanunu.
Guerrero was a crook, a liar, a cheat. He's perfectly capable of doing anything.
Once the Israelis found out Vanunu was talking about Dimona, Mossad would be coming after him. And one source suggests they already were.
Mordechai Vanunu, 32, of Moroccan descent. I have four questions. What does he know? Where is he? How do we get him back? And do we get him back dead or alive?
Mossad had a fearsome reputation for eliminating Israel's enemies. In 1961, they kidnapped the Nazi Adolf Eichmann in Argentina and smuggled him to Israel, where he was tried and hung for his role in the Holocaust. After the murder of Israeli athletes at the 1972 Olympics, for 20 years, Mossad hitmen hunted down and assassinated their killers, wherever they fled to. And in 1986, Mossad were pursuing Vanunu.
We'll be in London within 24 hours.
Peter. The photos, they are lost.
Lost? Where?
I don't know. Someone has stolen them from me.
But they were in the hotel safe.
I know. It's a mystery.
You're lying.
Why? Why would I lie to you?
You tell me.
I'm sorry. Oscar said he needed to keep the photos for safety. I gave him the key.
But he's cheating you. All he cares about is the money.
If it was not for me, there would be no photos. Mori did not even want to develop them. I had to persuade him. He did not even want to tell the story.
But where are they?
No, no.
I have the photos. They're in a safety deposit box, and they're gonna stay there until you give us some money. I'm warning you. I'm on the next plane to London. If those photographs don't come with me, there's no deal, no story, and no money. Understand?
Vanunu flew to London with the photos and without Guerrero. According to one account, Mossad agents were on the very same plane.
Roger Wilshire, Max Pracknell, colleagues on your story. Robin Morgan, head of the Insight team.
Mr. Vanunu, very glad to have you here. Please. I mean, this was a classic whistleblower story, but it wasn't just your classic whistleblower story, of course. It was a whistleblower story on a global scale of global importance. And I think very few people, in truth, very few journalists have real experience of something like that.
Yeah. We wanted him.
We're not MI6, we're not the CIA, we're not Special Branch, you know, we're not the SES. How do you protect somebody like Mordechai Vanunu from the long arm of Israel intelligence and Mossad? We had to assume from day one that if they found out he was telling us what he was telling us, and he had photographs of what he had photographs of, that they would attempt to eliminate him.
At Greenham Common, the blockade of the airbase continued. Some militant women campaigners succeeded once again in scaling the perimeter fence. Critics might argue with their viewpoint, but surely not with their commitment. Mrs. Thatcher...
Your country people know where the weapons are and have the right to protest against them. Not in mine.
Okay.
I prefer classic.
I had no training whatsoever, and I don't think any of the other team members had any training or any experience, particularly in looking after whistleblowers or kiss and tell stories.
You are lost?
Oh no.
There were so many times around.
I was told by a friend it's a good precaution. That way you can see if anyone's following you.
I'm glad Mossad has met its match.
Yeah, well, we'll also be taking you out of the country for a few days. So we can sort things out here.
We were, I think it's fair to say, naive. He was naive, and let's face it, we were up against one of the most sophisticated and effective security services in the world.
Subsequent events indicate that by mid-September, Mossad operatives were already gathering at a safe house in London. Their first job, to follow and observe Vanunu.
Mordechai.
Professor Frank Barnaby, a leading nuclear scientist. He used to work on the British bomb.
Pleased to meet you.
Likewise.
Well, my role was to confirm that Vanunu knew what he was talking about, putting it crudely, to test the scientific value of the knowledge he had.
The only real purpose for the reactor is to supply Machon 2 with radioactive fuel rods.
How much plutonium are you producing from the fuel rods?
At the end of the process, we would get a button of plutonium, 130 grams. We made about 9 every week.
9?
Yes, 9. It's a lot, is it?
How often was the plant operating?
Usually 8 months in the year.
But that's enough for 10 Nagasakis each year. How long has this been going on?
I'm not sure. Maybe 17, 18 years.
That means Israel could have up to 200 atom bombs.
200? And they think this will bring security? But it will never bring peace.
Why would they need all those weapons, you know? At that time, how many targets would there have been for nuclear weapons? One can think of 6 or 10, but certainly not 200.
In World War II, 6 million Jews had been exterminated by the Nazis, with no one to defend them. Israel was determined to have a last line of defense it could rely on.
The notion is that Israel should have capability for the worst case scenario. In order to prevent Auschwitz and the memory of Auschwitz and the respect to Auschwitz, Israeli leaders felt that Israel should be in position to threaten with Hiroshima. And if, God forbid, Israel would have to face that kind of eventuality, Israel would have a weapon of last resort. That's what people call the Samson option.
The Samson option owed its name to the Jewish hero who killed many of the Israelites' enemies as he brought about his own death.
You believe him?
I do. Photographs are authentic, he doesn't pretend to know everything, he's not a con man. He's very sincere. His memory is great, almost photographic. And I'm sure there are plenty of other things he can tell us about.
But?
What if he's being allowed to tell us all this?
How do you mean?
Suppose the Israelis are letting him blow the lid off Dimona to deter an Arab invader. What if he's a plant? Probably doesn't even know it himself. The Israelis have always wanted the world to think they might have the bomb.
I simply couldn't believe that a technician would be allowed to take nearly 60 photographs inside Dimona, take the film out with him, and then travel the world, end up in Australia. I found that very hard to believe, so I smelt a rat.
You okay? I'm glad to get out of there.
Vanunu was a man of contradictions. A Jew from Morocco, he'd always felt an outsider in Israel, but fought for his new country in 1973. Facing an identity crisis, in the 1980s, he befriended radical Arabs hostile to Israel. He'd risk jail to get the photos, but had no idea what he'd do with them. In Australia, he became a Christian and turned his back on Israel. But when he bumped into an Israeli friend in London, he insisted he'd be allowed to meet him for dinner.
Could you look after him tonight?
Me?
Yeah, he's going for dinner with a friend. Go with him, ask a few questions, find out what he's all about.
All right.
Yeah? Okay. White no sugar, please.
Wendy Robbins was a Jewish trainee reporter on work experience with the Insight team.
It certainly hadn't occurred to me as a 21-year-old on my first assignment in London that a foreign security service were following us around the streets of Trafalgar Square. And no one at the Sunday Times had actually said to me, you know, Mossad could be onto this guy, be really careful. So I went off to meet this guy called Yoram Bazak, Mordechai, briefed by the Sunday Times just to keep my ears open, listen to the conversation that was going on and try and work out whether this was a genuine coincidence or whether this guy may be working for the Israelis.
All right.
I don't know. Yoram is a nice guy. We were at university together. It's just strange to meet him here. Can I put my arm in yours?
Look.
It's just we are supposed to be going out together, and I told Yoram I'm bringing my new girlfriend and not a reporter.
No problem.
Thank you.
I'm so glad he has met you. By the time he left Israel, he was hardly talking to Jews, were you, Mordi? He's always mixing with Arabs, talking communist ideals.
Some of them had PLO connections, that is all.
I sometimes wonder if he thinks Israel should even exist.
We took the land from the Arabs to create Israel. Now maybe we should give it back.
ולאן אתה והחברה שלך הייתם הולכים אם הייתה עוד שואה?
Has he always been like this?
I fought to defend Israel in 1973. Perhaps you have forgotten that.
And then it all changed, didn't it, Mordi?
That's right. When they invaded the Lebanon, Israel does not want peace.
Bullshit!
What if I told you Wendy works for a national newspaper and I'm going to talk to them all about where I worked? You know what I mean.
My friend, if you do that, I will find a way to take you back there and have you locked up.
Yoram Bazak has always denied any connection with Mossad. For Vanunu, it was a clear warning of the reaction to expect from Israel.
Thank you for this evening. I'm just so sick of those men asking me all those questions all the time. They bore me.
Yeah. You prefer it when you can answer back, right? Have you thought about the effect this will have on your family back home?
I thought about it night and day for 6 months while I carried the film around the world in my rucksack. I went to sleep, asking what I should do. And I would always wake with the same question.
So your mind's made up?
Yes. No one is going to judge it.
Taxi!
Path I have chosen.
Good night, Mordy. Take care.
He was brave, he was foolhardy, he was heroic, he was gullible and naive. He was such a mixture of all those human extremes. What happened to him? I mean, that was not justice, that was real Old Testament punishment.
Sunday Times.
Good morning, Miss Robbins.
Oh, it's you.
Yes, it's me. So tell me, what do you think of my life story then?
And then I met a girl. Very funny. I'm flattered that I get to mention, but maybe you should concentrate on the important stuff.
Mossad were under orders to silence Vanunu and kill the story.
Hello? Okay.
Their job was about to be made a lot easier by an unexpected arrival in London.
Mordechai, enough already. I've got work to do.
Sunday Times.
Yeah, dude. Where is Vanunu?
Peter.
Oh, Christ. What does he want?
Hello?
Where's Vanunu?
I'm afraid I can't help you.
Oh, I see. Yeah, no. You tell me where is Mori. I have to reconsider whether you can have the story.
Give me your number and I'll get back to you.
No! I need to speak to him. I need to speak to him now.
I understand.
Give me your number and I'll get back to you.
Okay, I'll give you my number.
01?
Uh-huh.
7204477. You can call me on that number.
Okay.
Yep, bye.
Hello. My name is Oscar. It's nice to see you. This Sunday Mirror is the best paper in the country. And I have here for you the biggest story you have ever had. You ready for this?
How does a new country with a few million inhabitants become the world's sixth biggest nuclear power without anyone knowing?
They must have known. It is a fact that France built a nuclear reactor. And built Mahon too.
This is nuclear proliferation, aided and abetted by those pretending to oppose it.
And not just one country.
there were other countries involved too.
There was a long list of Western countries who'd be very embarrassed if Vanunu's story ever got out.
Norway is one that supplied the heavy water for the reactor. France, of course, supplied the reactor. Britain also supplied heavy water, and the United States arranged for quite a large amount of highly enriched uranium to be shipped to Israel. So all of these countries are complicit.
America was the key. A secret agreement allowed Israel to have nuclear weapons.
In a meeting between the Prime Minister of Israel, Golda Meir, in 1969, September 69, when she visited the White House, and US President Richard Nixon, the ground rules that in fact governed the way that Israel conducted its business at home, but also in terms of dealing with the United States and the rest of the world, were determined. And not much has changed ever since.
It was agreed the Israelis could keep their bombs, but they must remain secret, because publicly, America was against nuclear proliferation. By now, Vanunu was almost certainly under round-the-clock surveillance from Mossad.
Stand by, they're coming out early.
I saw Verdi in Sydney. It was much better there.
I wouldn't know, you're the expert.
It just wasn't what I'd hoped.
Story of your life, right?
Sorry?
What is it?
Don't know. Something bad is going to happen. No, you don't know these people.
Hey, it'll be all right.
I'm so sick of all of this. I feel cold inside.
It's just a hug, okay?
He was really desperate for female company, and he really, really liked me. He definitely kind of wanted to have more than the friendship that we had, and I explained to him it was out of the question.
12th floor. What are we doing up here, Mordy?
I wanted us to eat dinner in my room.
No, Mordy. Get yourself back in here.
It was my role to keep challenging him, like playing devil's advocate, to try and draw him out.
You're a coward.
What do you mean?
If I thought there was something wrong with my country, I'd stay. And try to change the system from within, not blurt out my complaints from the other side of the world.
I will never go back, never. Israel treated us like Moroccan shit, the same at Dimona, run by European Jews. They used us as a sanjar, you understand? And because I had Arab friends, I even paid one to spy on me for a year. So you have no idea.
Thank you.
I am sorry.
It's fine.
It's just that I feel so lonely. I want now to finish all of this and to get on with my life.
Have you thought that what you're doing may put Israel in danger?
I owe Israel nothing. I am not an Israeli anymore, and I am not a Jew. Mm-hmm. All the suffering in the world happens because people divide themselves into groups. Now I am a citizen of the world. I don't want the land, and I don't want the religion.
Why are you doing this?
Because I have to. And because nuclear weapons are terrible things. And for a little bit of revenge.
Mossad had been ordered to take Vanunu alive, but afraid of a diplomatic incident, Israeli Prime Minister Shimon Peres had instructed them not to kidnap him on British soil. They had to find another way to spirit him out of the country.
I am sorry. It's just that I feel so lonely. I want now to finish all of this and to get on with my life.
He wanted love. The guy had spent 10 years underground, working as a nuclear technician. He was lonely. It was as simple as that. Unfortunately for him, that was his Achilles heel, and Mossad very rapidly worked that out.
Do that.
For the so-called honey trap to work, Mossad would have to get Vanunu alone and entice him to make the first move.
It's a great view up here, isn't it?
It's a good view.
Listen, do you mind if I...
No, you can go.
Spot on.
We plan on Sunday, September 28, to run a major investigation piece, finally confirming the long-suspected existence of Israel's nuclear arms capacity. Israel has, in fact, since 1970, been steadily accumulating the material for such weapons at an annual rate of between 6 and 10. And there are now the makings of over 100 fission missiles in her nuclear arsenal.
On Tuesday, the 23rd of September, the Sunday Times gave Israel the chance to rebut the allegations. Till now, only the Big Five, China, France, Britain, the US, and the Soviet Union, had publicly admitted to having a nuclear arsenal. Vanunu had provided the first hard evidence to show the world Israel also had the bomb. The next day, Israel denied the allegations. Mossad believed they now had just 4 days to lift Vanunu.
Oh, by the way, you probably won't be seeing me for a while.
No? Why not?
got my journo exam soon. But I'm way behind on my studying.
Oh, yes, you should work hard for those.
Yeah, you'll be all right without me, won't you?
Yes.
Good. Bye then.
Bye.
After a while, we just kind of left him to his own devices. A huge mistake. And I think it was only a matter of time before Mossad got to him.
Having a cup of coffee?
No, you know, I really should.
Please, I could really do with the company. I'm Morty.
Mordechai Vanunu.
Cindy Hounam.
Pleased to meet you, Cindy.
Pleased to meet you.
And shall we?
Yeah, okay. Why not?
Intelligence sources indicate that the very day Vanunu met Cindy, an Israeli merchant ship, the Noga, was ordered by Mossad to head for Italy at full speed.
Hi, I'm sorry, but I'm not going to be able to come today. I have to go somewhere.
Oh, okay.
But we can meet tomorrow
sure,
at my hotel.
Sure, tomorrow.
More questions?
Sunday Times whopping, please, mate.
And I've answered them all 100 times.
Yeah, but she's nice. She looks nice. Congratulations.
How long is this going to take?
The Sunday Mirror are doing a hatchet job on the whole story. They published this Sunday. Your friend Guerrero has really dropped you in it. He went to a rival paper. He told them his pack of lies. They found him out, and your name will be in it.
But you are publishing the same day. People will realize the truth.
I'm afraid not. The editor wants more checks.
But what for? Who we?
The other nuclear scientists.
You people are messing me around. And you know the dangers that I'm in.
Wait.
We think you should find a new hotel.
Fuck off.
He was getting very impatient with our process of investigation. We had to be sure, otherwise we wouldn't publish.
The Sunday Times had recently been the victim of a humiliating hoax, the bogus Hitler diaries. Afraid of being fooled again, they were now running still more checks with nuclear scientists on both sides of the Atlantic. But the delay left Vanunu at risk. The cards had fallen perfectly for Mossad.
Do you like Bach's fins?
I do, actually.
They are very popular.
Should we go get some?
No, the group. They win the Eurovision.
Oh, okay.
I love them.
I'm sorry I did not have your phone number. And they tried to change my hotel.
Tell me, do you like philosophy, art, opera? See, opera is my passion.
Then you should go to Italy sometime.
That's the home of operas, right? My sister lives in Rome. You should come over sometime, maybe.
Do you mean it? I want so much to get away. See, I'm going to be in the paper on Sunday because of something I did back home.
I am in a great danger, Cindy. You have to believe me.
What kind of danger?
Anything could happen to me. Anything.
Well, whatever it is, I'll help you get through it, okay?
What have we done?
That weekend, the Sunday Mirror printed pictures of Vanunu and ridiculed his story.
Were you meant to get $25,000 for this?
Did he know me?
Knows your face now. My poor Morty. You know, you really should leave her at least till this blows over.
No. I must see things through before I go.
But, Morty, I'm so worried for you now that I know everything. When is the Sunday Times publishing?
Next Sunday, maybe.
Maybe. Maybe not. Listen. Why don't you come to Rome with me? We can hide out there, together. Please? Who knows? You know, it could be fun.
Hello, Peter. I'm going away for a few days with my girlfriend.
For heaven's sake, don't. It's too dangerous.
I will ring in twice a day.
She could be Mossad.
Don't be ridiculous, Peter. I went up to her. Look, I will be back on Thursday, okay? So don't worry.
Mordy.
Hello?
Come on through.
Okay.
Do I feel a sense of responsibility? Of course I do, but I don't feel guilty because I think Mordecai made a catastrophic error of judgment. Even when he was warned by me, he still went off with this woman, and if he hadn't done that, the whole story would have been different.
Any sign of Vanunu?
No, nothing.
Wendy heard anything?
Nothing.
Christ.
We had this immediate problem. Why has he disappeared? Has Mossad got him? Has he done a runner because he is a con man? Has he done a runner because he is a hoaxer? Can we go back and double check?
We'd got the whole of the story ready, covering three pages of the paper, and we had this debate as to whether we should go ahead and publish the story.
My view, for what it's worth, was that we shouldn't publish because we couldn't produce the person, ultimately, who was going to provide the proof.
The Sunday Times finally decided to publish on October the 5th.
We had to assume the worst. And therefore, publication of his story, publication of his photograph, and all the evidence we had became his best protection.
Convinced that if we had not published the story, Mordecai would probably have been killed.
See what you've done? Your shit.
Israel was exposed as the world's sixth biggest nuclear power, a revelation widely seen as the biggest security failure in its history. The West's opposition to the spread of nuclear weapons looked utterly hypocritical. But curiously, the world's press didn't want to know.
In spite of all the evidence, in spite of all the photographs, in spite of the expert testimony of leading experts like Frank Barnaby, you still had the international press pouring scorn on the story.
Since the matter is sub judice,
Vanunu had been silenced, but not for long.
The government would like to inform that Mordecai Vanunu is detained in Israel by law under a...
The Israelis revealed Vanunu was in Israel, but not how he got there.
Participated. The rumors as if Mr. Vanunu was kidnapped on British soil, kidnapped quote-unquote on British soil, have no foundation whatsoever.
On his hand, Vanunu had written hijacked in Rome and his British Airways flight details. But the Israelis never admitted to his kidnap. At his trial, he was banned from talking about it. Convicted of treason and aggravated espionage, he was sentenced to 18 years, the most hated man in Israel.
Every decent Israeli hates Vanunu. He is a born traitor. He betrayed his synagogue, he betrayed his nation, he betrayed his country, he betrayed his working place, he betrayed his colleagues.
For 11 years, Vanunu was in solitary confinement. He often feared for his sanity. Vanunu was released in 2004, still unable to leave the country and under heavy restrictions.
I am a symbol of the will of freedom, that the human spirit is free. You cannot destroy the human spirit.
After 18 years, Vanunu and Hounam were reunited.
Good to see you.
The main point is succeed. I survive.
That's good.
Be strong like me. You will be
strong.
Look, there's no question that Mordecai did not succeed in what he was hoping to do, which was to help bring peace to the Middle East by forcing Israel to either get rid of its nuclear weapons altogether or to put them under international supervision or reduce them. None of those things happened. The world just ignored it.
Israel has kept the nuclear weapons the West helped build. And the Middle East remains the world's most volatile region. To some, Vanunu's a hero who exposed the hypocrisy of the West in aiding nuclear proliferation. To others, he's a traitor who gave away Israel's atomic secrets, strengthening the hand of its enemies. Iran now claims, just as Israel once did, that its nuclear power would be for civil use only. But the specter of an atomic arms race hangs over the Middle East as never before. Next week, the world's most dangerous nuclear smuggler. He stole Europe's atomic secrets, built the Islamic world's first bomb, and sold the technology to enemies of the West. The gravest threat of all, it falls into the hands of terrorists.
In fact, you can see that program on Friday the 16th of February at 9 o'clock. That's because of the verdict next week on BBC Two. Next tonight, meet one of the world's most popular healers.